Yes. The moment we've all been waiting for.
I feel the need.
The need for speed.
Exacto.
All right, taking off in 3, 2, 1. IndyCars, a lot of people know this, are the fastest race cars in the world. They hit about 390 kilometers an hour. So to be able to capture that, we needed to create just the fastest filming drone in the world. From day one, we started on the drawing board. There were a couple drones with similar designs as this, and we used them as reference, but we always knew we wanted to improve on them, make them faster, make them more efficient, make them more powerful. So this configuration is completely developed by us. From every single part we design, every 3D print, every carbon fiber cut, and all the electronics were all very rigorously spec'd out by us and tested by us. The goal today is to have the drone completely built, everything configured, and then tomorrow we'll actually make it fly at high speeds. So there's a lot of work we need to do today to be sure that's gonna happen tomorrow. Connection failed.
Yeah, so I updated the firmware.
We have video. So now we can see from the camera through the goggles, and that's how we're gonna pilot the drone. The ultimate goal of the project is, from the very beginning, we reached out to some of the IndyCar teams, like McLaren, and pitched a product to them, and they loved it. They were super excited to be able to get something so fast and so close to the cars where you could really feel and see the speeds that they're achieving. So this is why we have this super aerodynamic shape, so that when the drone is flying at high speeds, it's basically like a torpedo or a missile.
I don't think anybody really believed us when we pitched this.
Yeah, as Amberly said, probably like when everybody first heard this, they weren't very optimistic. But I think we found a really good team. We worked really good together, and this really helped, you know, be able to push this and have a successful project and successful product. We're here at the Northeastern Denham campus with the high-speed drone we've been building for the past couple months. The build is complete. We were up until like 2 a.m. yesterday building this. We started at 11, so it was a good 13 to 15 hour build, but we're super happy and super excited that it's ready. The GPS is set up, so we're gonna have super precise and accurate positioning and speed, as well as altitude. The goals today is to obviously evaluate the performance of the drone. We're planning to do a couple flights, maybe 3 or 4. We'll start off slowly, doing some really basic discovery flights, hovering, and then from there we'll be slowly ramping up, and ultimately we will try to push it to its maximum power and see what are the results we get. Hopefully it's over 300 kilometers an hour and near 400. So if everything's successful today, we can then use it to film productions, film high-speed objects like IndyCar racing, Formula One racing, and any other high-speed object. And let's go out and fly.
All right, we ready?
Yes, sir.
I've got it forever. Yeah.
How do you feel? Excited, nervous?
Yeah, a mix of both. Definitely.
Such a, crazy
a lot more excited. We've been putting a lot of time into this build, and it's also a bit scary to fly because, you know, things with drones and especially prototypes, like anything can happen. You know, I trust the build and what the team did and everything we put together, but
All we can do is hope for the best.
The weather is pretty cold and a bit misty, but air density does improve the flight performance in the drone. And if we have a lower temperature, we're gonna keep the electronics cooler as well. So I think we're in optimal conditions.
Yeah, the red one's good.
You got it?
Yeah.
Like this.
Good.
We have three battery packs, but time-wise, like, do we have time for four flights?
Yeah.
Let's slide this on there.
Beautiful.
Okay. Let's hover.
Should be good.
Nice, that's sick. Should I screen record, David?
Yes.
I feel like just first, arm, disarm.
Arm,
just
disarm.
To see if it freaks out, if like a motor direction changed anything. But yeah, not too much. Perfect. We just want to discover.
So just go up and down after that? And up
yeah.
Okay, ready?
Ready for takeoff.
Let's take off in 3, 2, 1.
We have a liftoff.
Nice. Very good. Okay, let's do the goggles on. You ready?
Yes.
Taking off in 3, 2, 1.
Amazing.
Great. So we're at 46 volts now. We're still good for one more?
Yes. Try to get maybe 50, 60.
Okay.
We'll watch battery voltage, we'll watch everything. You just focus on throttle percent.
Thank you.
Try to hit the middle of the field. There you go. There you go.
62.
Beautiful.
And you're at 45 volts still.
Amazing.
Yeah?
See. That was voltage,
nice.
Right?
Yeah. How are we feeling?
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah?
That's like warm, but not hot.
Oh my god.
It could get so much hotter.
Let's go, dude.
Good shit. By the time it gets here, if it feels good, just go.
Okay. All right, taking off in 3, 2, 1.
Keep going.
The cloud ceiling is super low. Okay, ready?
Yes.
So that was exciting. Not really sure what happened.
Rescue mission.
We just lost complete control of the drone. We didn't lose video. So the team went to go look for it, and we're gonna see if we can find it and see what went wrong, so that we can make the version 3 more reliable. If we recover the drone, we'll be able to have more info, what went wrong.
Wow, look at that.
I think the tree's pretty
tall. Time to review the video.
Yeah.
Each prop video lost connection with the drone. Uh-huh. The video is fine, but the radio lost connection. We don't know why that happened.
We don't know why.
But yeah, pretty hard landing.
Yeah.
Yeah, this could definitely be rebuilt. I think we got some good data.
Yeah.
Good test runs on the electronics and the performance. But yeah, we can definitely rebuild.
Yeah.
V3.
Just the frame.
Yeah. It is honestly just the frame and soldering everything. Mm-hmm. Another 13 hours a day.
Now it's 13 hours a day.